Hello everyone, in this video we are discussing about comparison of overhead and underground transmission lines. That is, in brief, we are learning about how to lay down a conductor in case of a overhead transmission line and also underground transmission line. For what type of power transmission we will use underground transmission and overhead transmission lines, whether it is used for bulk transmission or else whether it is used for a small power distribution or else used for a bulk power transmission or else any other thing, and what are the advantages, disadvantages, what is the size of conductors we need to use, and what are the different factors related to that we are going to learn in case of a overhead and underground distribution transmission lines. Here, coming to the first slide, it gives you an overview about overhead transmission line, that is how the structure will be and for what type of power transmission we will use this overhead transmission line. Fine, it is a structure which is used in both for transmission and also for the purpose of distribution to transmit electrical energy for a long distances. And in case of this transmission, we can use one conductor or more than one conductor for transmitting the power, and these are suspended by using different types of poles and towers. There will be different types of towers, A, B, C, D. These are nothing but types of tower which are used to transmit the power depending upon the distance. And proper insulation is provided with the help of air, and it is the lowest cost method of power transmission for large quantities of electrical energy when compared with the underground transmission. So here, these are the types of the transmission based upon the voltage level. That is, there are different types of voltage level, from voltages to kV, mV, everything. So for less than 1000 volts, that is which is used for connection between a residential or for small commercial customer and the utility. And there is a medium voltage distribution, that is 1000 volts to 69 kV. There is high voltage less than 100 kV, and sub transmission or transmission voltage 115 kV, extra high voltage over 230 kV. There is ultra high voltage higher than 800 kV. That is, in India we will have a transmission voltage of 760 kV. These are all the overhead power transmission lines classified based upon the operating voltage of that particular line. So if it is for 1000 volts, it is called as low voltage. If it is between 1000 volts and 69, it is called as medium voltage. And if it is greater than that and less than 100 volts, it is called as high voltage. Similarly, we have extra high voltage and ultra high voltage. And these are nothing but a different types of lines. This is a single circuit line, double circuit line, parallel lines, and also a four circuits on a single line. So depending upon the construction of a tower, design of a tower, we will have a different lines on that for transmitting the electrical energy for longer distances. And these are the advantages of a overhead transmission line. Electrical power generated at power plants must be transmitted to ultimate users to carry the heavy loads for over longer distances. These transmission lines perform the heavy duty work and require stronger supports and larger wires. Yes, that is, the size of the conductor should be very large and proper protection should be provided, that is proper insulation should be provided around that particular conductor. And the advantages of overhead transmission line with respect when compared with the underground transmission line are given as: first one is installation cost, second one is repair cost, third one is environmental concern. Installation cost. When deciding whether to put a transmission overhead and underground, installation becomes a primary concern. The advantage in initial capital cost goes to overhead lines. It is more advantageous to lay down a overhead line when compared to the underground line with respect to the cost. Coming to the repair, it is very difficult to find out a fault in case of an underground, and to repair that particular fault, it may take
much time when compared with the overhead transmitter. So it is more advantageous for repairing, and also the cost of repairing in case of a overhead transmission line. Coming to the environmental concern, while overhead transmission lines may be considered NCIT, they did not impact the environment in manner ground lines when crossing the large expanse of land. Now coming to the next one, underground transmission lines. Underground transmissions are also a type of overhead transmission line which are used to transmit the electrical power or distribute the electric power for distances. But this type of underground cables or transmission lines are mainly used in case of a highly populated areas, but it has some disadvantages that the initial cost of power transfer and distribution will increase, and the advantages is nothing but the cables which are present in the underground will not get affected from the thunderstorms or the ice storms or whatever it may be due to the lightnings or else any other thing which are coming from the environment. And the operational cost will also be increased in case of an underground cables when compared with the overhead transmission lines. The lifetime of cables is quite high when compared with the overhead transmission lines. And this is the structure where we are showing the cables which are laid under the ground by digging a pit type structure here. Advantages. The main advantage of laying a underground cable is nothing but it is least affected to the weather conditions like lightning, wind, breezing, and the emission of radiations is also very less. And underground cables needed a narrower siding strip of about 1 to 10 meters, and there is no chance of having a low flying aircraft to wildlife. Much less subject to the conductor theft or illegal connections. There is a less possibility of having a illegal connections in case of a underground cables or underground transmission lines. Burying utility lines makes room for more large drains on sidewalks. Disadvantages. The disadvantages of underground cable compared with the overhead transmission line. First thing is nothing but higher cost of construction, higher repair cost, potential risk from careless digging, are more subject to damage by ground movement, cannot be uprated and must be supplemented or replaced to increase the capacity. So these are the disadvantages of an underground cable when compared with a overhead transmission line with respect to the point of construction, repairing, finding out a fault, maintenance and everything. And comparison of overhead and underground cables, now we will see. Comparison of overhead power lines to underground HTS cables. This is the structure. What you are seeing in this present line represents the top point represents the transmission, sub-transmission and distribution in case of a overhead transmission line. And the part which is present here near to that particular thing, that is down of a transmission, sub-transmission and distribution, represents the underground cables. This is the comparison table with respect to public safety. The first point, with respect to the public safety, overhead system is less safe whereas underground system is more safe. With respect to the point of initial cost, overhead system is less expensive and underground system is more expensive. Coming to the occurrence of faults, faults will occur frequently in case of overhead line as because of cables are laid over the towers. And the rare chances of faults may be occurred in case of an underground. Appearance, it gives a shabby look. It appears good. Why? Because we can't see the cables as they are laid under the ground. Flexibility, the flexibility of overhead system is very high when compared with that of an underground system, where the underground systems are not flexible as the conductors are laid in new channels. Location of fault. Fault can be located easily in case of an overhead system. It cannot be easily detected as the cables are laid under the ground in case of a underground cables. Repair can be easily repaired in overhead. It is not easy to repair a system in case of a underground. Working level voltage, it can work up to 400 kV. it can work only up to 66 kV due to the insulation difficulty. Coming to these are all the other differences: lightning, thunder, supply interruption, frequency of accidents, interference with the communication system, insulation cost, erection cost, uses. So this is the table which gives you the difference between the overhead transmission line, underhead transmission line with respect to the different points. Outage impacts. Outages are more frequent during normal and severe weather conditions. Repairs can be typically made within a day in case of a overhead transmission line. When coming to the underground, outages are less frequent. Repairs can take up to 6 weeks, minimum 6 weeks. It will take 6 weeks to repair a fault and to maintain that particular cable in a working condition in case of a underground cables. Coming to the cost of a overhead line, this gives you the cost to construct $500,000 to $1,000,000 per mile to construct in case of a overhead cable. This gives you the representation of cost for laying down an overhead transmission line and also an underground transmission line. These are the factors which represent the construction impacts. Thank you.